everyone. So, let me first update you with how I'm doing and how I'm looking. So, I don't know if you can see quite well, but this is the leg that went on the surgery, I mean the knee, and this is my okay leg. So, there is still a difference in muscles, and I still need to work on that and get the left leg to be equally strong as the right leg, which is probably gonna take a little bit of time and a little bit of extra workout, but it's gonna be fine if it means that, you know, my left leg can be as muscular as it was before. So yeah, this is the situation now, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the new weekly vlog. I forgot to tell you that. First of all, let me tell you that last week I didn't post a video, mostly because Anil had to go to the urgent care. He had surgery. It was one of the problems he is dealing with for quite some time now, so it's been repeating now, and he had to go to surgery again. Thankfully he's okay now, although he's resting here, as you can see, and yeah, just taking antibiotics and relaxing, just chilling. That's basically it. He has to, you know, take it easy, obviously. So yeah, he's doing that. So he's on his sick leave as well as me. So we're both on sick leave. So yeah, he's gonna be until he's okay, obviously, and until he's able to fully go back to work. And I have my sick leave till 20th of October. I got the letter from the health committee this week. It was, I think, on Tuesday. And yeah, I'm gonna be at home till October, and then on 21st, well, this is actually Saturday, so basically on the 23rd I'll be going back to work. So I actually thought that I was gonna go back sooner. I legit thought I will probably go back in like the beginning of September, but then my orthopedist, I don't know if I told you, I think I did, said that I need a physiotherapy and I need kinesiology, if I said that correctly. So I guess they understood that that's gonna take a while to get everything done, so maybe that's why they extended the sick leave till October. It might be because, you know, I have a lot of I mean, with the health committee, usually what they do is they extend you for 1 month, and then you have, your doctor has to send another notice so they can extend your sick leave, like mostly every month. Like, for example, since I started my sick leave, my doctor had to put in the notice every month, actually. So this is the first time that they extended it for like 2 months, but this is also the final notice, so maybe that's why, because it says that, you know, after the 20th I'm fully capable to go to work, which that didn't say on the previous letters. So maybe that's why, but hey, it's still okay. I'm actually going to physiotherapy already, and I'm going to the same one that I did at the beginning of my surgery, actually, but it's a different location, even closer to me. So I'm walking there, and I have like a less than 10 minutes walk, very, very close to me, which I love, because I have it every day at 10:30, so I'm gonna have it next week as well, and then I'm actually done, and then I have to move on to the kinesiology, which is a little harder in a way, because like physiotherapy is just kind of making your pain go away mostly, but then kinesiology will be the one that kind of brings me my strength back. I am doing some exercises in my physiotherapy as well, but not nearly as much as I will in kinesiology, because my orthopedist did say that the kinesiology is actually the one where they focus on, apparently they focus on your strength, and that is the part where I'll be like getting my muscle mass back, which I'm very excited for, because even my first day at physiotherapy, which was on Tuesday this week, when she you know, examined me and she looked at my legs, and then she was like, oh yeah, I can see the difference, it's quite noticeable. So I was like, I know, I really wish it wasn't, but you know, I can't expect much since I had like surgery 6 months ago, so I can't be
fully back to myself as I was. It's gonna take probably up to a year, if not even more. So I'm kind of mentally prepared for that, but I'm still kind of hoping that, you know, it might get better sooner. I mean, my physiotherapist did say today, as she was looking, she was like, "You're making progress," which made me very happy, because it's like, what, 4 days since I started. So she was like, "Yeah, you're getting, you know, I'm getting a little bit of a progress, but it's still a progress." So I'm very happy. And I remember, you know, a few months ago, let's say 2 months ago, I didn't even have the muscles I have now on my left leg. It was mostly just like a flat leg, which I'm very not used to. So it's kind of weird to see like one muscular leg and then one flat leg. So I wasn't really used to that. So yeah, I'm doing as much as I can to, you know, bring back my muscles as quickly as I can as well. So yeah, I've also started riding a bike way more. They recommended that to me. Well, they are mostly recommending me the indoor bike, which I don't have, of course. And then it occurred to me, because we have this so you basically pay like a subscription fee, like a yearly subscription fee, and then you have the unlimited, you pay a subscription fee, yearly subscription fee, for a bike here nearby. And we have a lot of stations over the Ljubljana. And then you can use the bike for 60 minutes for free. And then if you go over an hour, then you pay, can't exactly remember, I don't know, maybe 1 euro per hour, or maybe even less, I think. I'm not really sure though, but I never use it for more than an hour. But if we're going out, although we never did, because I only started using it like last week. So even though I had it here for, I don't know how many years, I just started doing that now. Mostly because everyone told me that I should kind of focus on, you know, biking. And so I was like, why not? I have it here. So this is how it looks like. Well, those are my payments. I don't know. I went here. But yearly subscription is 3 euros, which is nothing. Then here we have a lot of different options. Here you have my profile. I'm not going to open it because there are some personal information there. And then let's go to the map. And then this is basically your location, and then you have the stations around, and then it says how many bikes are available here. So as you can see, it's none here now. But then I have another one here, which is 6 of them, another close to me here, 20 of them, which is very good. And then, yeah, you have a lot of different stations, and it's a very good thing that it says how many of them are they. And then if you also want to park it somewhere, you can just, you know, turn to park and see how many parking spots are available. Usually there are quite a lot of them available. It's harder to find a bike rather than park a bike. So yeah, I used it today as well, and I usually do that in the evening, and I go with Kali out. I go on a bike, and she's just close to me, and as I'm riding bike, she's mostly running. But if I see that she's like really, really tired, then I slow down so she can like walk easily and kind of get her breathing back. I'm glad I started doing that, because it's just the best exercise. Like, I miss that. I haven't, like, I don't know when was the last time since I rode a bike. I think it was quite a few years, I would say. But I also have a station close to my work, so I'm able to go to work with the bike, which is the best, really the best. And even if, like, the station is literally so close to me, I just walk out of my flat and it's literally there. But if that's gonna be empty, which most of the time it is, I have still 2 stations. I have to walk maybe like 10 minutes there, but it's okay. I mean, still, I love it. So for that kind of weather, like nice, sunny, warm, even when the autumn comes, if it's not rainy, I can go with the bike. If it's rainy, then yeah, obviously the bus. But if it's not, the bike is just the best. So yeah, I decided I'm gonna use it very, very much so. And I love it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go to my work with the bike as well, because why not if I can? But seriously, I had that here for so many years and I just started using that. It's like just so funny to me. I had that like in front of my nose and just, yeah, basically under my nose, but didn't care to kind of look at it. But now, since everyone recommended that so much, even the orthopedist, the physician, then my doctor, everyone was like, just ride a bike, go ride a bike. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna do it. Then I started it and I'm loving it. So yeah, but I'm also gonna go take a shower because I did sweat a lot now. And Kali's also tired. Look at her. I don't even know if you can see her. She's over there. You can see a little like a white spot over there. And that's Kali. She's very, very tired. And I am too. So I'm gonna take a shower and I'll catch you tomorrow. Here is Kali living her best life. It's very hot today though, so I mean, it's been for the past week, so we're kind of surviving, but I'm trying to give her the exercise she needs as much as I can. But then also, I forgot to tell you, I actually, a few days ago, well, I wasn't like, it was like 2 weeks ago actually, I did get my nails done. Vanessa, my neighbor, she has the, you know, pedicure kit for that. I mean manicure, sorry. And I had my nails, but then I couldn't, I mean, I, not that I couldn't film, but I kind of forgot to film, mostly because, you know, Anel had his surgery and stuff like that. So by the time I picked up my camera, I didn't have my nails anymore. I mean, I have had them for like 2 weeks, I would say. They were really cute, but we're gonna make them again maybe next week or something like that. So I'm gonna show you when they're done. But yeah, I really wanted to show you, but then this week, I think it was maybe like Tuesday, I saw that they were just like ripping off slowly, like little piece by piece. And then I was like, yeah, I'm not, I'm just gonna get them off. So I took a warm water, then put the dishwasher in, dish soap, sorry, dishwasher, a little bit of dish soap and salt. I put my nails in for roughly 20 minutes and then it just all came off. So it's a really good method to try if you want to take the nails off by yourself. And it's quite easily done. Like all I had to do was just like scrape under the nail and then it literally the whole nail, well, not, you know, my nail, but the fake nail came out. So, I mean, we're talking about gelish nails. I'm not talking about like gel nails, the one that, what's the word? The one that, you know, are longer, the ones that are not your nails. I'm talking about that, basically. I didn't have like long nails. I was just putting the layers on top of my nails, so that's why it's easier to get that off. But with the gel nails, it's, I think, a completely different method. I haven't tried it because my nail technician, she was always, you know, getting them down for me, obviously, even the last time that I decided to, you know, not have them anymore. So yeah, but if you want to try it, you know, with the normal nails, dish soap, warm water and salt for 20 minutes, you'll be fine. But I'm also gonna love you and leave you now. I'm just gonna enjoy this day today. And apparently next week it's gonna be raining a lot, so it's gonna be a cozy day and night in, probably, if it's gonna be raining the whole day, we'll see. But the weather is drastically gonna change. Obviously, it's, you know, September is coming, autumn is here, so we're coming to an end of summer, which, I don't know, maybe I'm even glad that we are, because it's been way too hot here, and then I couldn't go literally anywhere. I didn't have my vacation. I was mostly at home trying to walk around and ride a bike around here, but I couldn't do much. So I'm kind of relieved that, you know, September is going to be here in like a few days, and that, I don't know, the cozy weather is going to begin. It's just kind of, you know, I got a message, kind of feels a little bit better for me personally. So yeah, it's just good for my soul. So yeah, I'm gonna love you and leave you now for sure. Thank you so much for watching this vlog, and I'll hopefully see you in my next one. So stay safe until then, you guys. Bye.